I have made a huge contribution to where we are today in terms of the infrastructure we have put in place. When I have had an opportunity to make a contribution, the contribution is loud and it is clear. The people of Kenya can see my fingerprints on the success of this government. They can see my footsteps in what we have done as a government. Unfortunately, when we lost the plot, so to speak, the country went in the wrong direction. And I want to take this opportunity, because I understand it well, to railroad Kenya so that we can move in the trajectory that will create jobs, will create opportunities, will sort out the cost of living, and sort out the debt issue.
You're running on this hustler narrative. Are you a hustler?
If you look at where I came from, vis-a-vis my competitors, you will understand why every Kenyan actually thinks I am a hustler. You know, politics in Kenya has been around people who have brands. Either your father was this or your father was that. The competition at the moment is largely between the current president, the son of the former president, the son of the former vice president, and all those. To put it much more clearly, I have grown my career from nothing. And I have climbed the ranks and learned the hard way to where I am today.
Are you disappointed that President Uhuru Kenyatta is not backing you for the presidency?
Well, to be fair to President Uhuru Kenyatta, we didn't have a deal. I decided to support Uhuru Kenyatta on the basis of my belief that he deserved an opportunity. It is him who made a commitment to himself and to the people of Kenya that he would support me. As for Uhuru Kenyatta supporting me or not, it's not the point. The point is, I have a plan, a solid plan. I have an agenda, and I believe I have the capacity to deliver on this plan and to change the destiny of my country.
In terms of your manifesto, some have argued that you're not really strong on the issue about corruption, which is a big problem in Kenya. Is that fair criticism?
We have a solid plan on dealing firmly, decisively, and conclusively with corruption. Number one, there is absolutely no reason why the judiciary continues to beg for money from the executive. We will operationalize the Judiciary Fund, which is a constitutional instrument, to facilitate the judiciary to hire all the men they need. Today, corruption cases take up to 10 years. We want corruption cases concluded in months. Number two, there is absolutely no reason why the DCI, why they continue to beg money for money from the office of the president. We will give financial independence to the criminal justice system. They will go after everybody without reference to the office of the president. And number three, we have put it in our manifesto that we will deal firmly and decisively with entrenched, chronic corruption that has taken over institutions and turned the whole country into state capture.